First of all, let's define what exactly A/B testing is. You might know this already. Even more, you might have even run your own A/B test before, and that's fantastic. Either way, I felt it was important to start from the very beginning, so when we go further with more complex concepts, we can build on rock-solid fundamentals. Okay, here is the most basic A/B testing example you can imagine. I'm sure you have encountered it in case studies before, or you have run it yourself, the red button versus green button test. When you run an A/B test, you take a piece of your online presence. Well, in this case, it's a button on your website, but it can be many other things. Any element of your website, an image, a headline, a whole landing page. It can be a PPC campaign, for instance, a Facebook or a Google ad. It can be a newsletter email, the subject or the content of it. It can be many things. But the point is, you take a piece of your online presence, like this button, you set up two versions of it, in this case, a red and a green version. These two versions will run parallel with each other. Any visitor who comes to your website will be randomly assigned to one of these versions. Usually, we use a 50-50 split, which means that half of your audience will see the red button, the other half will see the green button. And then you measure your conversion rate for version A and version B, then you will run the test for a while, and when you have enough data, you compare the versions to each other, and whichever has the highest conversion rate, that will be your winning version. It would be nice if it were this simple. But if you are here, you know that already, that this only seems simple, and that the test can go wrong in many places, so you should be very careful and methodical, even with a simple A/B test like this one. Besides, you can also add more complexity to your experiments by testing more than two versions, by changing more than one element, by using a less ordinary audience split, for instance, not a 50-50 split, but a 70-30 split, and so on. So let's go deeper. Well, before that, one more thought. When I see people running this red button versus green button test, I immediately know that this must be one of their first experiments. Why? Because usually they choose this test because they have no better idea. They read the red button case study somewhere, so they decided to give it a try, but that's not a really good idea. To run a great A/B test, you should always consider the context, you should run initial research runs, and just in general, you should reflect on your own audience's needs. And the red button is quite rarely something that a visitor to your website needs. With that said, don't worry if you have run, or even if you are currently running a red button test, it's just perfect for trying out what A/B testing is. I've been there and done that too, just like everyone else. But by the end of this course, you will learn how to come up with a million times better, more promising, higher potential experiment ideas.